appeared on the internet at 3 o'clock this morning.
My declaration of war against the United States of America and its allies. Until every last foreign soldier has left Georgia, this war will continue on American soil and around the world, claiming the lives of the aggressors. The scales of power have been newly balanced, and we will no longer accept the tyranny of the United States.
Blamed the U.S. media for their part in spreading Combain Nikoladze's message. Ironic counterpoint to the situation at home, U.S. soldiers in Georgia and Azerbaijan have spent their fifth night without combat. Though tensions remain high, military intelligence has been unable to locate any remaining Georgian commando. Have dramatically increased their efforts to find Combain Nikoladze. U.S. intelligence is combing a constantly expanding search radius extending from Georgia. Each new country, another possible secret alliance with the...
Because what we have here is a situation where further airstrikes just won't do any good. Nikoladze's army, if that's what you want to call it, is a bunch of...
As mourning relatives prepare funeral services, America's law enforcement and military forces prepare for the unknown, waiting for Combain Nikoladze's next move.
Kalinatek Building, Langley, Virginia, USA, November 1st, 2024, 0124 hours. Recover the encryption key. Russian mercenaries have begun to destroy evidence of Georgian activities at Kalinatek. Before her detection, in the network, Grimsdottir discovered that a technician named Ivan is hiding in the building. Ivan possesses an encryption key that could help third echelon to find Nikoladze.
Fisher, your mission is a man named Ivan. When Grimsdottir got made in Kalinatek's server, Nikoladze's mercenaries got spooked. They're pulling up stakes, wiping out all evidence of their presence, including Ivan and his comrades.
Who's Ivan?
One of Nikoladze's geeks, a programmer.
They're killing their own men.
It's all evidence. Let's pray you find him first. Details on your OPSAT.
So, greetings, fellow woodlings. I'll just go out and... Wait, welcome back to some Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. I'll just go ahead and say this. This level is a nightmare. Well, the stealth in this level is at least. Let's try and make it so that we don't, you know, end up dying. So right off the bat, you can see these two people here, and sneaking past them is going to be, well, pretty difficult to be honest. But we shall try nonetheless. I mean, that's what we do, right? So this level is pretty combat heavy, and they want you to just go ahead and just shoot and kill everybody you can see. But let's see how far we can manage without going for that. Let's just wait here for a second, and let's hope none of these people see us. I mean, this guy should be able to see us, but he isn't. So I suppose that's good. I wonder if he can sneak past behind this guy. But then again, I mean... The good thing about this level is simultaneously also the bad thing, that this level does not have any alarms. Developers also did a pretty good job of designing it pretty carefully so that, you know, we don't accidentally...
I think I see something.
And if we are gonna have to take these guys out, then might as well do it right now. Because I really can't think of many other ways to go about this level. If you know of a way, then that's good for you. I don't. So... Anyway... I'll just go ahead and create a save here. Let me just go ahead and check whether there is a way we can do this peacefully. Let's see here. By the time we reach here, these guys are already out. We can't exactly do much about it. The lights are pretty much useless. They don't really provide much of a purpose. We can't seem to be able to jump up to grab this pipe. Either. Can we grab it from here, though, I wonder? Nope. does not exactly seem to be possible either. So I guess, I might try to distract them once, but I don't really think that is going to work all too well. I could sneak up behind this guy, but it's going to be pretty difficult even in such a scenario. Because this guy's literally standing over there, getting a shot off to any other corner is going to be a little difficult. I guess it's what it is then. Anyway, I'm just gonna... Yeah, I did save there, so... Okay. So... I suppose that's the only thing that we can practically do at this point.
You have blood on your shoes.
So I do.
This is terrible work.
The order came down directly from Gringo.
Yes. If I didn't fear him like the Reaper, I'd be long gone.
He told me to think of them as sheep. He says we are thinning the flock.
Okay, let's try this now. I got an object, I can lop it over to that end, and hopefully that'll, I don't know, buy some time, I guess? Let's see here.
Weird. Hey, what is that?
Nope. No luck. Well, if I have to go out for a firefight.
This is terrible work.
The order came down directly from Gringo.
Yes. If I didn't fear him like the Reaper, I'd be long gone.
He told me to think of them as sheep. He says we are thinning the flock.
Oops, yeah. So, now how do we approach this problem here? Do we just peek out from here and shoot them both? Really? It was that difficult for you? Really, Sam? Oh well. Whatever works, I guess. And yeah, we're just gonna leave them dead there. Because that's pretty much all that we can do. And we want to take a little bit of a run up here and try and jump this gap. Well, the run up wasn't really necessary, but yeah. Jump out of this pipe. I mean, you can literally jump down from right here, but you'll be losing some health. And this is the correct way to go, so yeah. The first time around that I was playing this level, it was actually pretty difficult for me.
West wing of deep water is clear. Moving on to 6.
How many encryption keys did you retrieve?
This is our 7.
And what we need to do from here is practically jump the gap over to that end, I believe. Yes. And we'll find some supplies here? Do we? I don't recall. Anyway, this is the grappling point.
He's dead?
Come on, you can see his brain. Of course he's dead.
What about his encryption key?
The key?
Yes, the encryption key.
I got it. It's destroyed. Let's move on.
Alright, so that's that. Let me just equip my pistol here. There are a lot of shootouts in this level. And, well, there's practically no way around them, to be honest. Yeah, let me just get my rifle out. Hopefully I won't be needing it, but you never know. Yeah, so that is the guy that we want to take out next. And just leave him lying there, because, well, that's the Kalinatek way, I suppose. Let me just go ahead and pick savior funds, because I haven't done that in, I think, some time. Let me see if anyone's here who's gonna spot me. Doesn't seem to be. why we need to kill this or knock this guy out is because we need his satchel. And yeah, we need the security door keypad code from this guy. This level is mostly about killing everybody, so yeah, you have it. Ah, Valery to Arkasa. Metal detector. Timofey. No, the metal detector cannot give you cancer. Your guard post is a safe one. Don't let yourself get distracted. Today's keypad code for the security door next to your post is 97531. Please commit this to memory and destroy this message. Thanks. Edic. Well, I guess he did not commit this to memory, did he? Anyway, I'll just go ahead and save you. Whoops. Yeah. We want to be just a little stealthy here. Wait, what was the code again? Damn. 97531. 97531. Right. At least this part of the level involves a little bit of stealth, I hope. And we want this pouch of ammunition, because trust me, we're gonna need it in this level. We're gonna need as much ammo as we can get. Keep your handy, this optic cable, optic fiber thing handy, because you're gonna need that a lot. Yeah, time to go a little slow. There is a lot of glass here. And we just want to make sure that we can climb up into this, into these ducts here. And that's that. I'm just going to pick save here. And let's hope that whoever this guy is doesn't open fire, just because, as far as I know, he should. Oopsie daisies. Yep, see, there's a guy right in there, and given the chance, he is going to open fire, so just be a little careful. We'll be fine for the time being, I suppose. And what do we have here? Another guy. Let's hope he does not see us. Well, I suppose that was we were successful there.
East wing of port clear. Three encryption keys retrieved.
And the art files?
Destroyed. Every one of them.
Thank God. Make sure you leave the bodies where the fire will get them.
Of course.
And yeah, so that's that. We could have just come straight in through this path, but as you can see, we have got a few goons in our way who we do not want to upset, so might as well leave it. Oh boy. Yeah, so let's
last
see here.
Last week it was those turrets. This week it's wall mines.
So, I use the tools they give me.
You obsess over them.
You have to admit.
Yeah.
Yes, but if we plant too many, it's dangerous.
They're supposed to be dangerous. They're mines, for God's sake.
Let's see, how do we deal with this? I guess we don't need to. Would you like to move, sir? Perhaps go through that door there? Yes, no? It's actually my first time trying to stealth through this level because, well, it's Kalinatek. But anyway, I guess this guy isn't going to move, so I might as well just save my rifle ammo and take him out with my pistol. Come on, Odin. let's just dump him right here where there's a little bit of shadow, and I'm just going to switch this object to off. And let's see what this guy has in his satchel. Oh, it's a wall mine. That's amazing. That's amazing, really. Anyway, I'm just going to quick save and let's see. Let's see what we can do. We don't really want to disturb that guy too much anyway. And as long as you're moving slowly, it's all fine. Wall mines won't harm you. Get as many medical kits and as many bullets as you can from this level, because you will need them all. Trust me on that. There are a lot of firefights. Should I take this? Nah, I mean, wall mines aren't really of much use. There are two people here now. So I wonder, what should I do now? Should I just take them out and open assault? Or should I... I guess that was that, I suppose. I mean, there doesn't really seem to be a better way to do this. Data suite recovered from the satchel, and yeah, let's just hop in down here.
We just sussed a little more out of Ivan.
There's a group of mercenary programmers alive on the third floor.
They're trapped behind a cluster of wall mines.
You think they might have encryption keys?
It's worth checking.
Anyway, so I tried to pass through the first level without, you know, shooting anybody, but here we go. It's just trying to finish this level without, you know, violence just seems a little bit like exploiting the mechanics of this game. So, I mean, it is possible. I've seen a few people do it, but yeah, I don't think I would rather not do that, to be honest. From Edict to Ruslan, wall mines. Ruslan, Pavel says he's briefed you on the wall mines, but I want to make sure that you understand they are extremely dangerous. Do not think that they are a toy. The mines detect motion by emitting an infrared pulse every half second. If you move too quickly during that pulse, you're dead, Ruslan. So this is basically how the wall mines work. You need to walk up to them slowly and only deactivate them when they're green. If you place the mine on a wall, it will self-activate. It will beep rapidly for 1 second, then emit a solid tone for one more second. After that, it's live and dangerous, so set the mine and move back quickly. If you need to move a mine, approach it slowly, and only try to grab it when the green light is on. That is important. Grab the mine when the green light is on. You will know when you screwed up if the light starts blinking faster. When that happens, run away as fast as you can. Be careful, Ruslan. I worry about you. Edict. It's always heartwarming to see the relationships between, you know, terrorists. But anyway, I digress. Time for me to save again in this pretty horrible playthrough that I'm doing for this level. For stealth game anyway. I can hear some people moving around. I can afford to move a little faster. What the fuck just happened there? Let me attempt that once.
What is that?
Oh, nothing at all. You don't look at me and we're all good. I guarantee you.
Must have been nothing.
Yeah, that you are right about. It was nothing. Salvage is nothing. It doesn't even exist. Until he's about to put a bullet in your brain. That much I can guarantee you. Anyway, moving on. That seems to have been the plan for execution. Not that fast. I think we can afford to move a little faster, but not as fast. Anyway, so here's the objective. We need to rescue these people first because, I mean, we're heroes after all. Now, time to slow your pace down. And only grab it when it's green, like that. You need to time it properly, otherwise you're going to get blown to bits. That seems to have gone well.
I need an encryption key.
We don't have any.
Why should I believe you?
There is a bomb.
What?
The Spetsnaz planted it to destroy the data archives. But they put it right next to the gas pipes. It will take out this whole floor.
How do I get there?
You will need the keypad code for the door. I think it's 33575.
Grim, check the building specs. That geek's story about gas pipes holds up.
I'm on my way.
Make it fast. You don't have a lot of time.
I'll just reload and save ourselves some time.
I have your position!
Anyway, I'll just go ahead and reload my gun. Wait, I don't have ballista to reload my gun, but how amazing. Anyway, so yeah, what you want to do is when you get near them, just walk really slowly. Or alternatively, you can run past them. We're not in that much of a rush, so we're not doing that right now. So anyway, we want to... Archives department is 33575. Time is a little bit of the essence here, so you want to be as quick as possible. Again, slow your ways through these things here. There's another wall mine there, so beware. Take it slow, make sure you don't rush. And you're free to run otherwise. Crouch walking does help a lot, so yeah, make sure you're crouch watching whenever you can. I'm just going to quick save here. I probably should not have done that, but oh well. It is what it is. Yeah, again, slow. I'm not going as fast as I should be going. And that is quite sad, to be honest. You can go a little faster, just make sure that you're slow where you're supposed to be slow. And where you want to go is this door right in front of us. And yeah, we have to pick this lock here. Seriously? Okay, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Wow, these guys really made us pick 8 locks, huh? Climb up here, get down there, and just defuse the bomb. And that's it. Let's just go into the shadows and fix it.
Great work, Fisher. That could have been bad.
But we've got a new twist for you. I hacked into the power grid. Somebody's thrown the breaker on the fire door circuit.
Meaning you won't be able to open the doors until you found that breaker. Details on your offset.
Ooh. Okay, moving on. I mean, you can get those wall mines if you're really interested in them, but they don't really help you out much. Because most of the enemies that you're going to be facing in this level, you're going to be facing head-on for the most part. So, yeah, it won't really serve your purpose if you choose to pick up the wall mines and use them. So here's the thing. There are two folks here. Where we need to go is down there, behind the stage, and one of them is providing overwatch. Let's try and sneak by this guy, if we can. Yeah, let's hope he didn't see us, because if he does, it's gonna be a little messy. And what going down there will do for us is that we'll be able to use this code here, the keypad code here. We'll get that code at that point in time. And let's see here, let's try and sell through this area. without alerting both of these guys to our presence.
What is something moving over there?
Look into it. Well, the first stage was a success. So metal seems to be completely devoid of lighting. So we should stick to the middle then, right up until we reach this stage. At which point, I've got no idea what I should be doing. Or maybe we need to take those guys out. Let's try this here. For now, it's all fine. There's no problems. Do I want to create a diversion here just so we can sneak out to the rear end of this place? I think I do. I think I do want to create a diversion. Because the bad guys, they come up from this side. We want to, so hence we want to stay on this side so that the bad guys can see us. Let me just go ahead and create a quick save here. In case things don't work out in my favor, that is. So.
Who is that?
Yeah, and that's it. Unless I'm mistaken, we do not need to take those guys out. Unless we have to. So, in that case, well, who me? Anyway, I'm just gonna create another quick save here.
I just spotted somebody in the auditorium. Maybe our intruder. I need backup now.
Okay, time to rush a little, not too much. And yeah, just get in here. Don't need to worry much. This is a safe hiding spot. The bad guys won't be coming around again for a long time.
How the hell?
That must be crazy.
Maybe you are, son. Maybe you are crazy. Anyway. Now we can... I think we can safely step out. And we'll need a means to take care of this guy, unfortunately. We can't just let him slide. We can move a little faster. No point in playing it safe, I mean. So, we will need to take care of this guy, unfortunately. There's no other way around it. That's nice. That is very nice. I'm just going to take your body up and I'm going to hide it where there's just a little bit of shadow, you know, so that it won't be much of an issue for us. We want to get out of here, for example. Anyway, I'm just going to pick up your satchel, see what this fetches us, and let's see here, data stick. Philippe Mars to Timofey. Latest transfer. Timofey, you incompetent ass! What are you doing sending me insecure mails? Use pretty good privacy or don't send me squat. If you send me any more unencrypted mails, I'll have Gringo get intimate with your eye sockets. Philippe Mas. That sounds a little sarcastic, that name. Postscript. Of course, the air traffic files are useful. Sounds a pretty entitled, And the frag grenades as well, trust me, they'll be useful. So switch this object to off, and I think we can proceed now, I'm not sure. Let's see here, I'm just gonna do a quick save here because I don't remember whether those guys come out or not. As in whether they come back up or not. So I come back down. What am I even seeing? Anyway. Okay, let's try this again, shall we? Nobody bats an eye at this light, but they are going to bat an eye at this light.
How the hell?
Nice, nice, nice.
back.
And I'm just gonna climb up here and stay there. I suppose in a way they should have given me sufficient cover to maneuver through the chairs. In a way. Let's see here. Because the first time around I played this level, I literally just, you know, killed everyone.
That must be crazy.
Oh, wait a second. We do need to kill someone, don't we? Someone with a satchel. Who's got the door code for that door up there? I wonder who it is that we need to kill. So at least this side is clear, and hopefully there won't be a lot of people coming over in this general area to investigate. Even if they do, I mean, we can literally just crawl right in through here and keep ourselves safe.
That must be great. Must have been nothing.
Probably so. Why don't you go home and take a nice little rest? Why was this guy running? So yeah, we need that dude with the satchel, and I'm guessing he's up top, where no one can reach him. So yeah, now that that's done, we can practically like take any of these exit routes here. We can go a little faster, this flooring is sort of padded. And since it is dark, these people won't be able to see us. Now here is where it gets tricky. I suppose we can go from behind this guy. I suppose. That's right. Well, that worked. So who's the guy with the satchel here? Is it you? Yes, it is. And how do we nab you, I wonder? Because sir, we do need to nab you. Let's stay here and look at your patrol pattern for a while. I see. Reload for that. Let's see if we can afford going a little faster. Let's see here if we can grab this guy. We can, apparently. That guy isn't looking at us, so we're safe at the moment. Or so I would suppose. Now we're in the shadows, and I can knock this guy out without any problems. Well executed, I'd say. So yeah, this is the satchel that we were looking for. Let me just go ahead and save the game here at save 1. Because I felt like I haven't made a proper save in a long time. And let me just go ahead and read the statistic. Yes, Edict to Dennis. Door code. Arkasha. Had to make a last minute change. The keypad code for the back door on floor 3 is 1250. Valera. Russian name sounds so cool, you know. Let me just go ahead and fix save here, because I don't know whether this is gonna make a difference or not. Whether we do get caught or not. So, might as well not take the risk and just... What was the code again? Okay, 1250, I see. 1250. Nice. So I guess that was a well-executed level. It took a while, but we finally found out how to get to it. And let me just quick save here, because I can see some guys up top. That is, by the way, where we are going. At least the general direction, where we're going to. So, yeah, might as well want to be a little... Ooh, frag grenade. I completely missed that. And some blood. Completely missed that as well. Huh. Let me just quick save here again. Let's see here. How do we want to do this? I wonder if sticking to the walls does anything for you. Doesn't seem to be thus far. Oh, it did. It worked. Damn. But how do we get past them now, I wonder? Now that we are here. I guess I'll just go ahead and quick save here, and we'll go back the same way if necessary. And yeah, let's try whatever we can from here. It doesn't seem like these guys are gonna go anywhere or do anything, but do whatever it is that you're doing. How can I move from here without possibly alerting them and giving myself away? This seems to be a nice exploited location. A shadow.
Who is that?
Good question, who is that? I hope you sincerely do hope that you won't be coming here. Oh, you are. How wonderful. Since you are, you can pretty much, like, just...
I found the man!
No, you did not. Shut up. I guess that's one way to do it. And I'm pretty sure there's gonna be another guy up ahead. So I'm just gonna, you know, pre-save here at this point, so that it doesn't really cause as much troubles.
Can you talk?
I don't want to die here.
Are you Ivan?
Who? No. It hurts. Please, take me to the infirmary.
Let's see here. So I don't remember whether, you know, we have to rush with this guy or not, but... Or whether we need to kill the guy who's coming first. Because if we don't...
You've got the subject in restraint, holding for interrogation. Please hold this position and await further instructions.
Nice. So I guess that was well executed.
Thank you. Who are you?
Do you have an encryption key?
They took it. Destroyed it. They've gone mad. I don't know...
I need to find a man named Ivan. He's locked himself behind the building's fire doors.
Then he must be on the fifth floor.
That helps. Thanks.
So tired.
Yep. And... Well, I just didn't want to take any chances, to be honest. And given how many enemies you actually kill in this game, yeah, that really wasn't asking for much, to be honest. Now that we've got multiple health kits.
We've got the subject in restraint, holding for interrogation. We'll hold this position and await for...
this guy died anyway. Might as well use the med kits in that case. And, let me just try shooting these lights out. Excuse me. Yeah, thank you. And yeah, I'm just gonna quick save here. And equip this rifle, because, well, this is pretty much... Did I save? I don't know, I'm just gonna quick save nonetheless. So, the server room. There's another guy in there that we, you know, need to get our information out of. Right there. And it's better if we take it a little slow. I mean, I guess we had to kill this guy in a way because we couldn't exactly trail him through this tiny little passageway that we have here anyway.
Bullet, do you read me? Bullet, I think I found something useful. A computer with a window that says Fire Emergency System. Bullet, are you there? Useless.
Useless he is. Hold up. I'm just gonna... let me just go ahead and create... I'm just gonna save here. Just for the heck of it. And luckily that was the correct save. We're gonna have to grab him anyway. And yeah. Oh, there was a way around back. Why didn't I think of that way? And that should cast a shadow on him. I'm almost out of bullets. Well, a pistol anyway. Moving on. Let's see. Oh, we can move fast enough.
Good work, Fisher. Opening those fire doors cleared your path to Ivan, but it did the same thing for the Russians. You better make damn sure you get to him first.
All right.
Update on your situation. To cover our asses politically, we clued in the FBI. We're gonna have to leave Ivan for them.
So what am I doing here?
Ivan's a technicality. All we need to trace Nikoladze is his encryption key. Get that, and we're golden.
Yes, sir. From a letter from Valery to an email, rather. From Valery to Timofey. Subject the Ark. Gringo. Ooh. I've gone very carefully through all the files we pulled from Dougherty's machine and can find no mention of this ARC. Your message suggested it would be high on CIA's list of threats to national security, but it does not appear to be the case. We'll keep monitoring Dougherty's PC and hope for the best. I feel strongly that we should not attempt to insert another peephole into Langley's data stream. I do not think we will be presented with another opportunity as advantageous as Dougherty. Sincerely. Avery. Huh. The funniest thing about this older trilogy, it's actually much easier if you literally rush through the levels. Anyway, moving on.
We already checked this hallway.
We might have missed something. We'll check it again.
How could we have missed somebody?
Listen.
Yeah, well.
Well, what?
Nothing. Hold on a second. I need to visit the little boy's room.
Make it fast.
Let's see here. Yeah, we just need to wait for a while that guy goes and takes a leak and never comes out because we practically nab him in the most undignified of manners while he's taking a leak. So yeah. Yeah, so we're just gonna rush a little here. It's fine. So it would seem. And that door to go through is right there, but yeah, we just like to take it a little slow. I think we can just get in here and wait as well. That was a long pee, to be honest. Who pees that long?
Who are you talking to? Who's on that phone?
Please, don't!
Tell me who!
Here!
I don't want the damn phone. I want you to tell me who you're talking to.
I don't know. I thought it was the cops.
And that's that. Where's just that pudding go? Dataset, let's go ahead and read this dataset before we talk to this guy. Yeah. Okay. Valeria to Slava. Error. Run. They've cut their phone lines. I hope to God this gets out. They're killing everybody. Don't trust Nikoladze or Master Gringo. Run away from them. I know you're stuck in some northern tundra of Russia, but it doesn't matter. Just run. The mercenaries they hired, they're killing us all. They're killing the programmers. Jesus God, I don't want to die. They're killing all. Tell the others, tell the programmers, they're killing us all. Huh. Okay. So, fine, let's just talk.
Are you Ivan?
Yes. You are American? You are police?
Yes and no. The police are on their way. Until they get here, I'm the only friend you've got, and I'm not a very good one.
We have to leave. We have to hurry. They'll find us soon.
That's not my job. I'm here for your encryption key.
That wasn't the deal.
The deal still stands. The feds will get you out of here alive, but first you have to give me the key.
That wasn't the deal I made with the woman on the phone.
Listen, do I come to your job and tell you how to murder civilians?
What?
No. So don't come to my job and tell me how to do mine. The feds are on their way or here already. You're gonna be fine. You can give me the key or I can take it.
That wasn't the deal.
You're working from a very limited phrase book. Listen, just give me the key. I'm tired and I hate making people scream. It gets me down.
Here.
Thanks. And until the feds get here, find a better hiding place.
God damn it!
You took your sweet time.
So that freeze right there, you took your sweet time, that's supposed to be, you know, played when the other guy gets back.
You're gonna like this.
It makes me nervous when you say that.
The Russians are all over the top floor.
From one cell to another.
We're gonna have to do some cleaning before the Osprey can safely touch down for extraction.
From one bathroom stall to another, that's literally the best place, hiding spot they've got. Anyway, so that phrase which you heard, you took your sweet time, yeah, that was supposed to be for... I mean, this seems clean enough. Yeah. Up. So basically that phrase you heard, you took your own sweet time, yeah, that was supposed to be for when the guy was being, who he knocked out returns. And since he never returned, I don't really know where that phrase came from. But here's the thing, this level is just gonna get a lot more difficult now. And you're gonna be glad you took every single bullet that you found. Shooting out lights and stuff doesn't really help you, the game more or less forces you into encounters. Yep.
I've got a corpse.
And that's that.
I've got a corpse here.
Who said that? Who said that? Anyway, that was a short-lived battle. Excuse me. Can I not climb onto this? I can. Good. Because that is all I really wanted to do. And yeah, from this vantage point, it's pretty easy for you to just go wherever you want to. That's it. That's as far as I get to go. Okay. If you say so. But yeah, it's best if you just keep quick saving in this level and keep reloading your rifle, because otherwise this level is a pretty messy one. You want to ensure that you've got everything that you can get before moving on to the next section, and it just features a ton of shootouts. There's no other way around it. You can't, you know, make it sound better than it is. This level, it sucks a little. I wonder if there's a way to get up there. So see right there, you're getting some ammunition. I suppose you're getting some ammunition, I'm not sure though. That looks like ammunition to me, that you can never be sure.
It will be over soon.
I wonder if I should experiment a bit. I'll just take the side out. Oh, I wonder if I should try and sell through this level. Even though at the moment it seems rather impossible, but who knows? You never know, right? And these seem to be nails, not bullets. My bad. Oh yeah, there's a box of pipe acid right there. That's what you want. Theater. I just blew up whatever was here. And that was quite redundant, but oh well, I mean, what all that we really need are bullets at this point. Nothing much else to be taken care of. And take as much of bullets. Take as many bullets as you can find, take as many explosives as you can find, and you'll be all fine. So keep your health up and keep saving. I'm just going to save here. I think I saved in the wrong slot there, but who cares. There doesn't really seem to be a better way to get into that place, so I'm just going to go ahead and shoot this light out here. Try to at least. Yeah, that makes things a little better, marginally. Or so, I suppose. Ah. I did that without need. You didn't even need to do that right here. Seriously? That's not how you throw a grenade. I hope you got that by now. Okay, that's done. Next guy. And I think that it takes care of everybody. Yes, it does. So, that's basically how this level goes. You need to go around and, at least the exfiltration part of this level, you need to go around and keep, you know, just taking everybody out. And, yeah, there's not much else to do here. Don't worry about the bodies, we... can I not climb this ladder here? Yeah, now I can. Fine. Not that it helps, it helped any, but... at least we got like a medkit refill right here, so that's a good thing, I suppose. Anyway, time to get back here, get the medkits. And just, I'm just gonna quick save the game right here. And let's see here. Where can we go? From here anyway. It's the same hallway. What is left in this place, I wonder? Okay. Excuse me, okay. Really do have a narrow target, don't I? Anyway, so that should give us a little while to survey our surroundings before we head into the firefight. Because there shall be another firefight right here. Trust me on that. See? That's one guy dead. Anyway, yeah, just use the frags. This game isn't really meant for shootouts, but Oh, so that's it. There's a bed. Guy was about to throw a crack grenade at me. How rude. Anyway, let's hope we can find some replenishments for ammunition here. No need to worry about the bodies as usual. Let's just get up here and see what we can do about these bodies at least. I do believe that is the way to go unless I'm mistaken. No packs of ammunition here. Let me just go ahead and switch the firing mode of my rifle. Huh. I guess there is no ammunition here. Good thing it's so noisy, otherwise it might have proved a little difficult for us. Both the parts are blocked. So there are also some people over here, which we can probably take out using the frag grenade. So I hope. Anyway, let me just go ahead and save here first. So quickly retry that, because I didn't want it to be that messy, so to speak. Let me try taking this light out. Let me try a better approach. Excuse me. Come on, Fisher, you can do better than that. Yeah, that makes things a lot easier. Let's see here. Frag grenade. Well, let me try this strat here. Okay, Let's try this strat instead. Let me mount the wall mine right here. And what I'm going to do next is let me try tossing the grenade through here. It doesn't seem like it's going to reach them, because I mean the walls are a little short.
Do you have a cigarette?
I just gave you one.
I smoke it.
Well, you've been standing here half an hour.
Let them just come out here, run out to their own deaths, I presume. Come on, what are you waiting for? Would you like me to shoot you, sir? Apparently you would. Nice. Well, a plan well executed if I've ever seen one. Or so I would say. If I had ever seen plans, that is. So yeah, that was good. That was as intended. I mean, we probably could have snuck past them, but, who does that anymore? Oh yeah, that reminds me, let me just go ahead and grab this 5.56 ammo here. Yeah, and now this is full, let me just go ahead and reload this. And I do not think we can take more of this. Anyway, I'm just going to quick save again, and off we go. We can literally just walk down that hallway, no need to, take the roundabout way. But one of the things which you cannot do is sneak through that place. So that is something I hope you guys do understand, that we need to take these guys out, no matter what. There's another wall mine right there, not that it would be of much use, but if you guys want it, you can have it. It's free, I mean, it's right there for the taking. And I'm just going to save the game here, because I'm going to rush through this place.
Because I see something.
Yeah, come on, mate. That's nice. I mean, we probably could have snuck past this guy, but since, you know, we are feeling so much as it is, it doesn't really make sense to sneak by one guy. Leave him alive while we kill the rest, so equality on all the sets of humanity. That is my motto. So if I'm killing one, I'm gonna kill them all. Deal with it. There's another stash of 5x6 ammunition there, if you do need it. Should you need it. It's strange, we haven't received a health kit in a while, have we? Or maybe you missed one, I don't know. Things are going smooth for the time being. Quite smooth, a little too smooth, if I should say so myself. There should be a guy up there, there's like a watchtower thing up there. So just take things a little slow, a little cautiously. Guy in here, there should be a guy out there. Yeah, there's a guy out there, and that's it. They just go ahead and put up a wall mine right here. And once I snipe that guy, this wall mine should help kill at least one of them. Let me just plant another here just in case, and hope that it does not, you know. Okay, so time for you to die, mister. Why did I even think that? I guess that's all sad. Yeah, that's all sad. Why did I even bother to waste like a couple of mines there? So that was that. There's nothing more here. The background music, the chime in this background music reminds me of the chime from... what was that game again? I think it was called... Eleanor? As you Americans like to pronounce it. Eleanor. And this is Richard, it's the fan. Boy, this guy got shot. Oh man. Okay, so time for us to equip our rifle and... So one of those guys is there. Ah, yes, right here. Another one of these guys is right here. Did I just miss him? Yes, in fact I did. Who else is there? Who else is there? I mean, a lot of people, what they like to do is that they like to run up the wall here and just grab that thing and get through, but... since that is technically... exploiting the games and the bugs, I would rather not like to do that, but yes, one of the things which I would like to do is... snipe these people out while I can, and yeah, it's not exactly a time-based event. You can take your time doing this. Because let's face it, I mean, you guys are gonna find out about it anyway soon. So. No need for me to spoil it for you guys, but yeah, one of our friends, you guys will find out soon. I did not get the cinematic, what? I think... Sam, more or less... Was I too late, perhaps? Because I think Sam gets to hear Redding's dying message. Not Redding, I forgot who this guy was. Anyway, Kalinatek building, Langley, Virginia, USA, November 1st, 2004. 00211 hours. The encryption key retrieved from Ivan allows Grimsdottir to trace a data stream back to a nuclear power plant on the Kola Peninsula of northern Russia, American intelligence's first solid lead to the whereabouts of Kumbain Nikoladze. Yeah, and here's the thing. So while this might say that the data trace leads us back to the Kola Peninsula in northern Russia, a power plant in that specific region, the problem is that that level has been removed from all of the other versions of Splinter Cell, Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, except for the original PlayStation version. So the versions that we're playing on the PC right now, on the Xbox, on the PlayStation 2, all of those versions do not have the nuclear power plant level. If it did, then Sam would go ahead and kill Philippe Mars there. But since it doesn't, we'll be doing that at in a bonus level called Cooler Cell, which is actually a completely different level as compared to as compared to the power plant. But yeah, the power plant is a level which is more or less exclusive to the PlayStation, the OG PlayStation. So we won't be playing that, at least. So yeah, it was a long level, but it was fun in a way. I mean, I did stealth through it for the first time, but anyway. So the next level, you're going to feel a sort of skip. I mean, there's some data which is missing, as can be seen. So yeah, I mean, that's just what it is. We don't get to learn whatever we do learn from the power plant. So let's see how this goes. So I guess that's it for today. Thank you for tuning in, and take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.